We have been live for almost 40 hours now on WION, bringing you every twist and turn in this election. From polling booths to candidate headquarters, our reporters spread out across America have been bringing you live updates as the situation unfolded. Take a look at this.
The largest team of correspondents covering every angle of this election. How the pandemic impacted this contest.
The biggest issue is the coronavirus pandemic. I mean, you know the statistics in the U.S., more than 9 million cases, over 230 deaths in the country. And so what Joe Biden has tried to do is definitely try to frame the election as a referendum on the president's handling of the pandemic. Meanwhile, the president is trying to say that only he can return the country back to its pre-pandemic prosperity.
The surge in early voting, advantage for Democrats.
Well, you're right. The battle in Florida expected to be really tight. You can see a number of people behind me casting their votes at the moment. What we haven't seen here in Tallahassee, where I am, is very, very long lines at polling stations. That's potentially because a huge number of Floridians, about 63% of registered voters, actually already cast their vote before we got to today. But the race here could be really interesting. In early voting, Democrats took a very slight lead, registered Democrats casting more ballots in early voting than registered Republicans. But it has been predicted that many more Republicans actually like to turn up on this final voting day.
Trump's last-minute campaign stops. Will the final sprint help?
Hard to tell, but I will tell you that passion runs very high for both candidates. If there is one thing Donald Trump is very good at, is making an exceptional closing to his base and his voters. And he's been very adamant and successful in going to state and trying to really bring up enthusiasm among his base. If you talk about enthusiasm, Donald Trump's base, I mean, you look at the pictures, you look at the video, you see him campaigning, notably in Pennsylvania just recently, and the crowds are, as far as the eye can see. Now,
the tight battle in key states. Who has the lead?
This election is on a knife edge. Polls were predicting that Joe Biden had a lead over Donald Trump in the national polls, 10-point lead. But in those battleground states, it was a close election. President Trump has won many of those battleground states. You've talked about Iowa, for example. These are states that he is projecting to win. And so, really, there hasn't been a blue landslide that we have been expected by the Democrats, but there hasn't been a red wave either. It is
Trump's chilling threat to stop vote count. Is it a challenge to mail-in voting?
We really are in uncharted territory, really, here. Donald Trump, as we heard a moment ago, suggesting that votes being counted after the end of the main election day here is somehow evidence of fraud. That is simply not true. There are votes that have come into polling stations and are still in the process of being counted. And to be honest, it's really not even clear at this moment if the president would have the legal pathway to do that via the Supreme Court. It's not clear yet exactly how that is going to proceed. I think what we can see and what we are already seeing, even though it's very late and it's the early hours of the morning here in the United States, it's just huge amounts of angst and concern about the uncertainty that this is creating.
As the election heads towards a nail-biting finish, stay tuned to WION for the complete coverage.
Thank you for watching Gravitas on WION's YouTube channel. If you want to stay up to date with what's happening around the world, then subscribe to our channel and don't forget to like and share. Thank you very much for watching WION. World is One.